is that people are treated and have been through a Hall of Fame. I started in 81, retired in 04. And I can tell you now that the opioid crisis is a classic example. You're talking about they go where the crime is. You know, Mr. McDonald, that the Senate and the Congress approved a lot of money to have people treated for opioid, where if they were to follow their own rule, they would have incarcerated those people that were 92% white use. And that's a felony, possession of. So if they had been run through the system, you might have had a different outcome as far as how people are treated, as opposed to the 80s when junkies were throwing the joint right quick. So until we address all of that and the despair that happens in inner cities, and you replace them with any group of people, any race, and you will get exactly the same result.
Appreciate your input, Valdez. Another comment.
Well, there's nobody incarcerated in prison for abuse. There's virtually nobody in prison for smoking a joint unless somehow that person is also a major dealer. That's a fallacy. The fact of the matter is that the so-called war on drugs has been instigated in every instance by people in inner city communities who understand the pull of living in an open-air drug market. Opioid abuse, I don't think that is going on in open-air drug markets. I think the sales are happening in a different forum. But this is something James Foreman is a Yale professor. Books have documented that the Washington brought up drug laws in New York City. It was preachers and newspapers in Harlem that were calling for the police to crack down on the drug trade because they saw this as a threat to their effort at achieving stability. Same with the war on crack. It was the Congressional Black Caucus that said this is the worst oppression that our community has experienced since slavery. Did the crack penalties ultimately get bid up in an effort to show sensitivity to a over-high